Today we have gathered here on the onset of International Conference on Renewable Energy for Sustainable Environment, Challenges and Remedies.
And good morning all present here. Honorable Shri Gangaji, my one of the best friend and my older brother too, who is presently Minister of Industry and Commerce, Government of Jammu and Kashmir, a man of new ideas, with new innovations, and perhaps a dedicated man to the industry, the right selection, the Government of Jammu and Kashmir. Honorable Sanjeev Janji, Vice Chancellor, Sri Mata Vaishno Devi University, etc. Honorable Professor Thank you, Bansal. In fact, I don't have words to say Professor Thank you, Bansal. He has been not only me, maybe thousands of students of this country, an architect to make their future brighter. In fact, we have learned the science and technology from Professor Thank you, Bansal. And today I'm happy to inform you, sir, today your four generations are available in this conference hall. Honorable Professor Rahim from Malaysia, Dr. Sanjeev Anand, Dr. Vivitiagi, and Dr. and delegates, honorable delegates. Friends, the subject selected by the organizing secretary, Energy for Sustainable Environment. Perhaps very right word for the country and for the nation. Perhaps certain times we used to discuss sustainable development. And while we have added the word, the organizers have added the word environment, makes it more and more wider. It does not only include the renewable energy, or perhaps the energy efficiency, which is the need of the hour, along with the renewable energy. I feel Jammu Kashmir is the one state which is 100% on hydropower, and that is a renewable power. And the right place to work on renewable energy in the country. In addition to that, Jammu and Kashmir also has, in particular Jammu region, has a very good solar radiation, and perhaps in the Kashmir Valley, the wind, appropriate wind speed. Further, this conference might be helping to provide the policies to the government of Jammu Kashmir through the Honorable Minister, that what they can do in future, what they can do in future for the development of the state in the sector of renewable energy. I know the Honorable Minister has a strong affection with the renewable energy because he has taken a lot of initiatives, as I have mentioned previously, based on green energy and technologies. I hope this particular conference and the outcomes will be very useful for the state and the country, and I congratulate the organizers and hope the outcomes of the conference will be submitted to the government of Jammu and Kashmir for further actions. Thank you very much.
Vice Chancellor, distinguished guests at the desk, my former colleagues and friends. First of all, thank you very much, Sanjeev, for inviting me, giving me an opportunity to come again here. And obviously, it is always a pleasure to meet you and visit the campus. Well, energy, obviously, everybody knows here. Very important subject, but it is becoming more and more important at this level for India, because when India plans its sustainable growth along with climate change, along its promise to supply 24/7 power, and also to develop the industry, agriculture, transport, and the buildings, it faces many challenges because the only fossil source that we have at our command is coal, We import 80% of the oil, which is a huge export bill, almost $200 billion a year. Obviously, in the process, India does a very clever job that if our demand is 200 million ton, we import 400 million ton, and we have very good refinery industry, convert them into petroleum products, and earn more than $100 million per year. Also, India has a capacity to store oil, which many Asian countries, Arabic countries don't have. And whenever a surplus is produced, they ask India to store the oil, which can be sold when the market of the oil grows. At present, oil is cheap, around $53 a barrel. It was very costly in 2008, but it's a very important source as far as the energy is concerned. So India faces many challenges. First of all, it has to supply energy, it has to preserve environment, and it is bound to develop its renewable energy, which has also challenges because renewable energy is fluctuating. It is not always present, and hence they have to have some storage techniques for grid parity as well as for short-term storage. I'll simply say one sentence because there are many people who have started. America became superpower because they discovered the first oil in 1901 with a capacity of 18,000 barrels a day. And that was the day which made America superpower. They could win the war over Germans because of the oil, because Germans used to synthesize coal, and the coal-produced oil had 40 times less capacity than the oil. They could reach much faster, they could strike much faster, their tanks were much faster, and without oil, America and allies, they couldn't have won the World War. The only country at the time of World War who were producing oil was America and Russia. Russia today is producing the maximum oil. Second is America, third are Arab countries. And therefore, the politics of energy determines who is not only economically powerful, but also physically who is more powerful. Since India is not so rich in its resources, they have to develop their own. We are good in renewable energy, solar and wind. And we have a plan to extend up to 175 gigawatt by the year 2022, especially in solar and wind. But the efforts have to be made to develop storage techniques, number one. Number two, reduce oil consumption in the transport and take a lesson from Europe as well as America, who are going to develop a fleet of battery vehicles by 2030, which will reduce the oil consumption in the transport by 60%, along with efficiency. And as taking these lessons and organizing such conferences allows you to interact with each other, take many new ideas for R&D, and help your country to be self-sustainable in energy, preserving its environment, dignity, and culture.
Very cool. Very beautiful country, all right? Adore it, okay? First time I'm very busy. Nice to be here, all right? And this is my first visit to the northern part of India. Right. And I watched this, especially in Hindi movie. Sangam, I think they got a lot of Hindi, very nice place. Now I can see real, it's alive, and this is a beautiful country. So, I'd like to thank to the organizer for inviting me to this conference. And I think that we are very happy to be here with two of my colleagues from University of Malaya. And there's nothing much I can talk about the renewable energy. I think that most of the guests here has talked very lengthy about the importance of the looking after the future of generation, talking about the importance about the looking after the, what you call, solving the climate change issue, for instance, and talking about the GHG gas emission. So I'm talking about this quite normal, and many people know about it. The question is that it's not only just say, but there must be an action taken in order to ensure that this is whatever that we are here can be materialized and make it work. And when we talk about this renewable energy, I'm sure that I think that I can say that India basically is the oldest country in the world, has looked into it for many, many generations. I think I'm right, right? Yes. Because that when I visited that, you know, you've been using all this sort of the resources, the energy resources, from waste to any form, has been used, utilized for many, many years and many, many generations. But however, due to the change of technologies, things has moved from different source of renewable energy, from waste to solar with the presence of the photovoltaic. And also we talk about the technology related to wind and biomass, for instance. And this has changed. And it become more and more, it become a mess rather become a small scale. And it's a very good platform for the conference today, the International Conference of Renewable Energy for Sustainable Environment. And we like to see the challenge and the remedies of the whatever that the presented today, whether the challenge can be what can say that we can look into it and look into the how to solve the problem and issues that we will face. And last but not least,
Parkash, Minister for Industries and Commerce, Chief Guest of the British Function, Prof. Bansal, former Vice Chancellor of this university, Prof. Bhddhi, VC, Suresh, Gyan, Vihar University, Jaipur, Dr. N. A. Rahim, Prof. Tyagi, Prof. Hon'ble. Today it is a great day for the Department of Energy. It is a new department in our university that they are organizing an international conference on renewable energy for sustainable environment challenges and remedies. The important word I find is the sustainable environment. As we feel in this today world with the increasing population, the demand of the energy is increasing day by day and the style that we are living. If I quote the older days, in our house we used to have one car. Now if a family of four, we are having six cars. So you can feel in which way we are consuming the energy. That is our main purpose. So the point is that what are the different other ways that we can generate the energy? And for that we know that the renewable source, energy source, is one of the important. And we, in our university, we are organizing an international conference on a topic which is of great importance, not over to the JNK, not over to this India, but to the whole world. As you know, our Prime Minister wants this complete energy is to be obtained from the solar energy, or the maximum energy is to be obtained from the solar energy. And I feel the deliberation during this conference will be very useful to meet the challenges of this nation. Normally what happens in the conference, we come here, we used to talk the good things, that's not an issue. But what the output will be of this conference is important. And as we are situated in the state like J&K, I feel that output of this conference will be very useful for the coming days, and we are going to set a path to which we can attain the sustainable growth in the energy sector. If we look about the different people around India, they are using a different innovations to generate the energy. But as such, we are not having any database. What are the different innovations that are going on in this sector? So it is also necessary to generate a database so we can have the different ideas that are used by the different people, which can be used here also. So I feel the Department of Energy will take the effort in that. So I once again congratulate the Department of Energy for organizing this conference. Thank you.
Dr. Sanjeev Janji, Vice Chancellor, Dr. N.K. Bansal, former Vice Chancellor, और आज मुझे लग रहा है उनको बहुत खुशी हो रही होगी क्योंकि ये पेड़ उनके हाथों से लगाया हुआ है. आज जो बड़ा छोटा पौधा लगाया है पेड़ बना है और कहीं पर भी जैसे आप आज बच्चे पढ़ रहे हो यहाँ पर, जब आप कभी जहाँ से जाने के बाद आएंगे तो आपको भी कुछ अलग सा एहसास होता है कहीं जाने पर. प्रोफेसर एन ए रहीम, डायरेक्टर UMPEDA University, Malaysia, Professor Dharmbhddhi, मेरे दोस्त हैं, बहुत ही होनहार मैं कह सकता हूँ, बहुत ही committed हैं, बहुत ही reliable हैं, मैं जितनी भी तारीफ इनकी करूँ वो कम है. Professor वनीत त्यागी जी, all HODs और यहाँ पर बैठे स्टूडेंट्स, आज जो वर्ल्ड कॉन्फ्रेंस जो रखी गई है रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी पर, मैं ये समझता हूँ कि आज अगर कोई सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट कोई चीज़ है तो वो एनर्जी है. क्योंकि हम सभी लोग जानते हैं कि जो हम आज एनर्जी यूज़ कर रहे हैं वो मैक्सिमम पेट्रोल डीजल जो हमारे जो जमीन के अंदर से जो हम निकाल रहे हैं और उसके भंडार जो हैं वो हमारे साइंटिस्ट बताते हैं वो कितनी देर चल पाएंगे और वो अल्टीमेटली एक दिन खत्म होने वाले हैं. तो जैसे वो ऐड आती है तो एक गाड़ी वो स्विच ऑफ करता है, उसका बेटा वो कहता है पापा हमारे लिए कुछ बचा दो नहीं तो हमें तो बाद में घोड़े पर ही जाना पड़ेगा. तो आज इस चीज़ की ज़रूरत है और मैं ये समझता हूँ कि इस कॉन्फ्रेंस की बहुत सख्त ज़रूरत है और आप बच्चों को बहुत काम करने की ज़रूरत है. अगर दुनिया में कोई चेंज लाई है, अगर हम स्पेस में गए हैं तो जो रॉकेट बना है उसका फ्यूल ही उसका कारण बना के सॉलिड फ्यूल लेके वो ऊपर गया. अगर वो वैसे टैंकी भर के जाता या तो वो खुद फट जाता या नहीं तो ऊपर नहीं पहुँचता कभी. तो ये साइंसदानों का कमाल है. आज हमारे इर्द गिर्द जो भी चीज़ें हैं उनका इन्वायरमेंट फ्रेंडली हमें एनर्जी जो है वो उसकी ज़रूरत है. आपको अपनी एनर्जी भी बनानी है और देश के लिए एनर्जी भी बनानी है. हमारी स्टेट में जो स्कोप है वो आपके सामने हैं, हाइड्रल एनर्जी है, हमारी जो बायो गैस एनर्जी है और विंड है यहाँ पर उसका बड़ा स्कोप है. सोलर एनर्जी हम देखते थे कि पहले एक बहुत बड़ा पैनल होता था तो बड़ी छोटे से यूनिट उसमें पावर आती थी, आज छोटे से पैनल में बहुत ज़्यादा एनर्जी मिल रही है. जो उसके फ्यूल सेल है उनमें बहुत मॉडिफिकेशन की गई और ऐसे फ्यूल सेल भी बनाए गए जो रात में भी काम करते हैं, अगर क्लाउड्स होंगे तब भी काम करते हैं. तो ये साइंसदानों का ही कमाल है. अगर आज हम लोग अगर तरक्की को देखें तो वो हर प्रकार से, और हमारे जो भारत के साइंसदान हैं वो दुनिया में, चाहे वो नासा है, चाहे वो
किसी भी टेक्नोलॉजी अगर देख लीजिए, बड़ी बड़ी जो हमारी जिन्होंने रिसर्च की है, साइंटिस्ट जो है हमारे इंडिया के जो हम नंबर वन रहे, हमारे डॉक्टर नंबर वन है, हमारे टीचर प्रोफेसर नंबर वन रहे हैं, एजुकेशन में हमारे लोगों का मुकाबला ही नहीं है। तो इस हम देश को तभी हम आगे ले जा सकते हैं, सुपर पावर बना सकते हैं कि जब हम एनर्जी में सेल्फ सफिशिएंट हो जाए और ऐसी एनर्जी हमें मिले। उसके लिए मैं ये समझता हूँ कि ऐसी कॉन्फ्रेंस जो है हमारे स्टूडेंट्स को बहुत उसका लाभ मिलने वाला है। मैं वाइस चांसलर साहब का इनका भी धन्यवाद करता हूँ कि जिन्होंने इस कॉन्फ्रेंस को रखा और बड़े अच्छे लोग यहाँ पर, इंटेलिजेंट लोग यहाँ पर आए और आपको इसका लाभ मिलेगा। मैं एक बार फिर यही कहूँगा कि अगर हमें इस देश को सुपर पावर बनाना है और आने वाले टाइम में अगर हम मान लीजिए कोई अल्टरनेट एनर्जी 10% 20% बनाते हैं, तो हमारे पास आज अगर गाड़ियाँ आप देख रहे हो कि अभी तो 20% लोगों के पास कारें हैं इस हमारी पॉपुलेशन में, जब ये 50 पर पहुँचेगी तो क्या हाल होगा, आपका क्या हाल होगा, हमारा क्या हाल होगा, आने वाली जनरेशन कहाँ जाएगी। तो उसके लिए सारी चीज़ों पर जो है विचार करना, सरकारों का काम है इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर देना और आप लोगों का काम है विजन देना और रिसर्च करना, ऐसी चीज़ों पर करना। मैं देखता हूँ कि कई बार बड़े बड़े अच्छी रिसर्च जो है हमारे स्टूडेंट्स करते हैं, हर एक फील्ड में मैंने देखा है, चाहे वो स्पेस की है, टेक्नोलॉजी की है, हवाई जहाज पे है, गाड़ियों में है। और दो चीज़ें हो सकती हैं, एक तो आप पहला नंबर तो ये है कि एनर्जी कम यूज़ करें, ऐसी गाड़ियां भी तैयार कर सकते हो। पहले ये होता था कि खुले गाड़ियां जो चलती थी बहुत ज़्यादा उनके जो फ्यूल जो है कंजम्पशन होती थी। दूसरा ये है कि वो फ्यूल एफिशिएंट हो जाए। मैं दिल्ली में देख रहा था, एक आदमी ने रिक्शा तैयार किया है, तो वो क्या है कि जब उतराई होगी उसकी बैटरी चार्ज हो जाएगी और जब चढ़ाई होगी वो थोड़ा सी थोड़ी उसको एनर्जी, जो एक रिक्शा चलाने वाला जो है उसकी 25% एनर्जी लगेगी, वो चढ़ाई भी चढ़ जाएगा उसी की स्पोर्ट से। तो ये उसको एक बैलेंस मेंटेन किया, उसमें एक बैटरी है। तो कुछ चीज़ें जो है वो हालांकि है वो पेट्रोल वाला रिक्शा है, लेकिन उसको इस ढंग से बनाया है कि आदमी की एनर्जी कम से कम लगेगी और उसको वो चला सकेगा, जिसमें कोई फ्यूल नहीं लगेगा। तो यही रिसर्च जो है ये हमें आगे ले जाएंगी। ऐसी बहुत सी चीज़ें हैं कि जो जिनको आप हमारे देश के लिए उसको आगे बढ़ाने के लिए आप काम करोगे, आपका ये योगदान है वो देश के लिए अमूल्य है। मैं इस कॉन्फ्रेंस में आए सभी जो हमारे रिप्रेजेंटेटिव बाहर से जो आए हैं, मैं उनका भी धन्यवाद करता हूँ और वाइस चांसलर साहब का कि जिन्होंने मुझे यहाँ आने का मौका दिया और आपके रूबरू होने का मौका दिया। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
Next, I request Dr. Sanjeev Anand to present a memento to our esteemed Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. Sanjeev Jain. Next, I again request Dr. Sanjeev Anand to present a memento to our esteemed guest, Professor D. Bhddhi. I now request Organizing Secretary Dr. Vineet Tyagi to felicitate respected Professor N.A. Rahim.
Directs, Dean and Heads of the different departments of the SMVDU, distinguished guests, faculty, staff, participants and my dear students, I am here to propose a vote of thanks on the behalf of the organizing committee for this 2 days international conference on renewable energy for sustainable environment, challenges and remedies, organized by the Department of Energy Management of Sri Mata Vaishnavi University. First of all, we are very thankful and honored to the Chief Guest Sri Chandra Prakash, Ministry of Industry and Commerce, who have accepted our invitation in very short time. We are grateful to you, sir. We are extremely thankful to the Professor Sanjeev Jain, Vice Chancellor SMVDU, of his gracious presence and his ever-ending support for this conference.